should never lose sight of the fact that any place-based restrictions, even seemingly minor restrictions, can seriously undermine the intrinsic role of freedom of assembly in enabling people to claim a particular audience that they are the people.
Is the Alliance for Defending Freedom, followed by the Toursum Centre for Strategic Studies. Sir, you have the floor.
I want to talk about freedom of assembly in Azerbaijan Republic. First of all, I want to inform you that after a couple of days, we have the next presidential election in Azerbaijan Republic. During a handful of days in 9 October, thousands of journalists, observers and non-governmental organization workers will descend upon Baku to watch Azerbaijan's next presidential election. Elections are important, but as we have regrettably seen around the world, they are often insufficient to establish democracy. Building the true foundations of democracy is a long-term process that involves so many tiny steps. When the international television cameras leave Baku, the Azerbaijan people and a handful of foreign helpers will remain to work all these small steps. They and we, all together, must not ignore shortcomings in Azerbaijan democratic development, whether in the upcoming elections or in everyday governance. However, neither should we ignore concrete steps that will lead to greater success. Fortunately, Azerbaijan is endowed with some of key ingredients that enable it to continue building a strong democratic society. Indigenous democratic traditions, a high educational level, devotion to secularism, modernization and mutual respect, remarkable economic development, and a pivotal position in East-West trade. The deep crisis of the socialist public political system and the breakup of a huge country like the Soviet Union in the early 1990s resulted in political chaos, economic paralysis, and social collapse in Azerbaijan, like in other post-Soviet countries. At that time, military aggression against Azerbaijan, the occupation of 20% of the country's territory, and the displacement of more than 1 million Azerbaijanis from their homes as a result of the policy of genocide and occupation pursued by Armenian nationalists extremely exacerbated the situation. The formation of a democratic society and transparent public relations in Azerbaijan in the years of independence formed the main basis of state policy. Political pluralism in the country became the necessary base of public progress in the country. Currently, there are appropriate legal and democratic political conditions for the free activists of political parties in the country. Today, 55 political parties are registered in Azerbaijan, and 11 of them are represented in the parliament. Political parties are closely involved in the public political life of the country and are represented in elected and other governmental bodies. Today, if we talk about freedom of assembly, I must say that freedom of assembly is an essential element of democracy. The extent of which freedom of assembly is exercised is often described as the litmus test for democracies in transition. The law of the Republic of Azerbaijan on freedom of assembly, last amended in May 2008, entered into force on 26 June 2008. The amendments to the law on freedom of assembly were initially drafted in 2005, and since then, on the request of the authorities of Azerbaijan, they have been subjected to thorough review by both the Venice Commission and the OSCE. The last opinion of the amendments was issued by the Venice Commission. If we see today Azerbaijan, so we can be sure that the freedom of assembly is guaranteed completely. I want to mention, as an example, a rally of opposition parties 5 days ago in the center of capital of Azerbaijan, in Baku City. For example, tomorrow at 16 o'clock in Baku, it will be the next rally meeting of main opposition parties. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your statement. Next speaker on my list is No Borders Ukraine, followed by the Center for Civil Liberties. No Borders Ukraine, you have the floor.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I want to focus more on discrimination.